Ladies and gentlemen, that is a live look at the Bravo team. This is the Destiny MLG Exhibition. I'm Chris Puckett, the host of The Desk, and I am joined by our three experts for the day. We have our local YouTuber and streamer, M-Dashed, as well as the Crucible Kings, our two Bungie designers. We got Derek and Lars in the house today. Fellas, today it's all about PvP. We are showcasing not only a new game mode, but also four brand new maps. Let's first talk about that game mode. Lars, what are we going to be watching today?
So yeah, we're going to be looking at Supremacy, our brand new mode that launches with Rise of Iron. It is a clash-based mode, so team deathmatch style. Every time somebody dies, they drop a crest, this big glowing object. The point of the game is to pick up those crests because that's the only way to gain points. If a teammate goes down, they drop a blue crest. Pick that up and you're denying the other team points. Super simple. Get kills, guardians go down, they drop crests, pick up those crests.
It's imperative. We got to play it a little bit. And it's insane how many kills you can outslay the other team and you can lose. We lost by 30 points even though we outslayed the team by 10 or 15. It's crazy how important it is to get in there, get those crests.
Can't wait to see this action kick off. And of course, we are going to be seeing four brand new maps. Lars, break it down for us. This first map that we'll be seeing is going to be Last Exit. Tell me about it.
Yeah, so Last Exit takes place on Venus. It's an abandoned train station, a subway stop, if you will. You're going to be spending a lot of your time inside. There's the broken down trains that's gone into disrepair. And then you have the outside, which is much more medium to long. Distance base, so you're going to see some snipers probably and pulses out there. Inside, much more shotgun heavy. There's one particular place that is a four-way intersection that we call pipes, and that's very dangerous, and a lot of action happens there.
Derek, in the warm-ups on Last Exit, it was all about the shotguns, but when we look at Skyline, who has the advantage here? Are we going to see more shotguns or sniper rifles?
Yeah, I think you'll see a mix. Outdoors, it's basically some pretty long sight lines, and there's a really wide range around the outside. Internally, there's an inside lobby that is a lot more close range, a lot more shotgun, hand cannon range.
All right, and then M-Tash, when it comes to Floating Gardens, you said this was your favorite new map to play on. What do you like about it?
This is the one that gets me excited. The flow of the map, you have some great engagements around that outside kind of apron overlooking the Black Garden. Then you go to the bridge. That's my exciting spot. You see a lot of supers there, a lot of multi-kills, and engagements like crazy. Everyone's going for the crests. This one's action-packed. Expect a lot of multi-kills.
Nova Bombs were dominating in warm-ups on Floating Gardens. But finally, we got Icarus. This is the PlayStation 4 exclusive map. Derek, tell me about it. What should we expect as we get to Game 5 with Icarus?
Yeah, so Icarus is a large symmetrical map. It's diamond within a diamond, diamonds all the way down. On the outside, on the left side, there's tanks, and that's more of a sniper range, but you can cut through and undercover and really get in there. Across the middle, there's a really dangerous close quarters shortcut. But we saw in warmups, we saw a lot of action around those tanks.
All right, so in today's exhibition, we're going to have five games, no matter what, but four brand new maps. Our first game mode will be on Bannerfall, but before we get to the games, we have to introduce you to our 12 competitors. We have two teams of six competing today, and these are made up of your favorite streamers, YouTubers, and of course, Crucible Pros. Let's take a look at our first seat here. That is Luminosity on the far right. He is playing with the Alpha Squad alongside Bodies, Vile, Sir Demetrius, Triple Wreck, and Seywallabra.
These guys are some of the Shotgun Kings, actually heavily favored. Everyone's tweeting it out saying Alpha is going to dominate, and these guys are extremely consistent. Some of the best shotgunners out there, period. So I'm excited to see what they do, especially with all that aggression that they bring to the table.
And you see, of course, our friend Triple Wreck in that red shirt. Everyone knows him. They've seen his stream. Is he the key player on this team? Who are you looking at to carry the squad?
Triple Wreck's good. We all know Triple Wreck's good, but that guy beside him, that's Sir Demetrius, young guy. There's Luminosity on the end. They're all so good. It's fractional changes, who's better, who's worse. You can't even compare these guys, they're all so talented.
It's a team effort in Supremacy, their competition on the other side of the stage. We gotta introduce you to the Bravo squad, and we're starting off with Frostbolt. The man closest to the camera has been going off with his shoddy all day long. Look for him to be dropping numbers, but so is the man next to him, that's N. Kutch. We're gonna have Lil Sonic, True Vanguard, KJ Hovey, and Real Crafty.
The Alpha team, going up against Bravo, the snipers. That's what everyone's saying, that it's shoddy versus sniper. But a lot of these guys have actually switched to the shotgun, trying to round out the team. All the YouTubers out there, you know, trying to make their plays happen with that shotgun, and they're actually doing very well. They've also got Little Sonic, who is, you know, for the most part, carrying the teams right now, going double positive in most of his games. He has the most multi-kills out there. I'm excited to see what they do.
I can't wait. The game is just moments away. Before we kick off the action here for Supremacy for the first time in the MLG venue, we have to get our predictions, starting with you, Lars. You've seen all 12 players. You've watched some warm-ups. Who are you going with today? The internet's saying it's all Alpha today.
And you know what? I'm going to go against the internet. Maybe not a popular opinion to go against the internet, but I'm really looking to Bravo. You know, I liked what I was seeing there. I liked their team play. And I know Twitter maybe, you know, thinks the other side. But, man, I got to go for Bravo. I love the underdog.
You love the underdog. What about you, Derek? Who are you going with?
Yeah, I got to go overdog on this. Alpha Team is just... Yeah, Bravo had some great teamwork in warm-ups, but Alpha Team has the killing power. You got to get those kills before you get the crest.
Got to go with the Slayers there on Alpha. M-Tash?
I'm going with Bravo. I've got some clan mates. I've got some friends. And, I mean, Alpha Team, you're doing good, but the teamwork, some of the bubbles from True Vanguard, I like Bravo.
Wait, you got clan mates playing in this one? Who are your clan mates? Who let you into their clan?
Hovi and True Vanguard. They're the clan mates.
All right, we'll keep our eyes on Hovi and True Vanguard, two of the older gentlemen in the venue today, 28 and 24 years old, I believe.
Yeah, absolutely.
They'll be bringing their gameplay too. Our first map is going to be Bannerfall, and this is a classic one, a pro favorite. Tell me a little bit about this level before we get into the action.
Bannerfall has some inside areas, but you're going to see a lot of the traffic out in the courtyard area. There's a tree area with, as you can see there, with two very prominent sniper lanes, but you got to be remembering there's going to be people sniping back. I think you're going to see a little bit more of the pulse rifles, the scout rifles, and the sniper rifles, but if shotguns get in close, get those crests, they can win. If you can't make it to those crests, you know, when you snipe a guy across the map, you're not going to win this game.
It's time to kick things off. We're starting with Lil Sonic from the Bravo team. They'll be wearing orange throughout our competition, and Lil Sonic in the warmups has been the best player statistically that I have seen so far. He's been getting it done with the man cannon, and tell me a little bit about this guy's game style. What is he going to be trying to do for his team?
He's moving in with that shotgun. He's very aggressive in his 1v1 engagements, but his IS Luna, his hand cannon there, he's making a lot of his engagements at a range count. His Nova Bombs also, we saw earlier, have been on point, getting multiple triple kills with it. He just needs to make sure that he actually gets those crests after he gets the multi.
And of course, this IS Luna, I feel like, is going to be one of the more popular weapons you're going to see here today. We allowed the players to play with their own gear. We ported it over, and now you can see him already going to work. That is going to be a crest pickup, a second kill opportunity. Luminosity.
Shade stepping away from him, and he actually completely runs away from the engagement. He uses that mobility. He realized he was at a place there that he did not want to engage, and now Lil Sonic is trapped in the middle there. There's a bunch of people on his tracker. He needs to try and win this one, get that crest, and he goes out on top, closing the gap there. They're now only 4 points behind. Oh, but it looks like a couple kills from the Alpha team. They got some crests. It's going to be close, I think, until Wallabra comes in with that shotgun to the face on Lil Sonic.
Speaking of Wallabra, we have his team up by 12. Now let's take a peek at the Alpha squad. I have to say, this is my first time casting Destiny, and I already love this. We have 12 players competing on a big screen in front of us. We will be showing you the best of the best screens, and Wallabra is known for providing the action. Unfortunately, going to lose that fight, but already 5 points to his name.
It's actually a little bit closer right now with that crest pickup there. It's only 4 points apart. They were, you know, engaging kind of in the inside area there where we saw with Little Sonic, but they're starting to push out into the courtyards, into the middle of the map, and I think you're going to see a lot of engagement trying to stay in this area because of the shotgun alleys in that inside building. There's just not enough traffic. You're going to get a lot more people in this middle of the map. Say Wallabra, again, he's kind of on fire right now, getting a few shotgun kills, but he's got a pulse rifle on this map, trying to use a ranged weapon, keep them at a distance if he can, and use that shotgun more defensively or if he's collapsing on someone with the team.
And you see the special ammo is coming up in about 2 seconds here. That is going to replenish the ammo in their shotguns as well as snipers. Grenades going out after securing the crest. Nice work so far, and he had his super ready to go as well. When should he use this?
I'm thinking he's going to be aggressive. He wants to try and generate orbs for his team, but with the blade dance that he's using, if he pushes in too aggressively, they're just going to team shot him. They're going to snipe him in the face, and he's going to get down before he does anything.
Now, Derek and Lars, I know you guys have been watching our big screen here. It looks like Alpha off to a pretty solid start. They're leading by 14 points. What has been the difference maker so far? Because now we're getting to the point where these players are starting to earn their supers, and this could be the game-changing moments.
Yeah, I mean, the initial play has been pretty good. We've seen Alpha team sticking together really well. But yeah, now almost everyone has their super up. We'll see what happens.
We could completely see a shift.
Yeah.
The game might go completely snowballing towards Alpha, or Bravo might come back, use some supers. Alpha team actually is going to have a little bit more of an aggressive play style with their supers, where Bravo has someone, True Vanguard, who's using a bubble shield. He actually just popped it. He's going to buff his teammates with Weapons of Light. Their primaries are going to be pretty powerful here, but you can just hear the supers popping off. There's a Stormcaller with Enkuch. He's in the middle of the map now across from True Vanguard here, popping off. He got one kill, but it looks like he got shut down by Saywall's Blade Dancer, so it's on super. Everyone is going down.
And we saw none of the kills. That's my fault, guys. Don't worry. I'm going to show you some more, though, and I have a feeling we're about to see Frostbolt pull out his any moment. He's been running with the Titan classes throughout our warm-ups, and what does he have available to him?
So he has an Electric Smash. He's going to go in, throw down his fist, and throw electricity everywhere. It's great for shutting down other supers, or in a panic situation when you're losing a duel, you can throw down the heat and pump them. It's it's really versatile overall, and hopefully he pops it here. There's a lot of people on his tracker, so I'm hoping he gets aggressive with it, tries to push in, grab some crests for the team.
It looks like a Bravo squad is kind of holed up here in the building. They haven't been able to push out into the courtyard thanks to those pulse rifles from Alpha, but there is a nice shoddy shot coming in. That credit will be secured by Enkuch, and now another opponent charges through. Enkuch is going to have to defend himself as we take our screen to him next. Let's take a look at the big picture here, though. 62-48. We're about a third of the way through the game, and this one has been pretty tight, especially in the last 2 minutes.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, Alpha team obviously has kept that lead for all of the game, but things can change very quickly here. I'm surprised things didn't change hand a little bit more with those super usages. Alpha didn't grab a giant lead here. Bravo didn't come back. It stayed within 20 points or so. Hopefully they can turn it around here with some nice snipes from Enkuch. He's got his last word out, which is an auto-firing hand cannon. So if someone does push in with the shotgun, he's able to take him out. And a crispy snipe from the across the map there on Sir Demetrius. He's looking for another target. He actually body-shotted them, getting the assist. So the team shots here with that sniper rifle is beautiful. And he's got another snipe on the body. Can he stay alive? Ooh, and he loses the duel. That was to Eyedrop Bodies with a nice pulse shot across the map.
Now, Derek, we saw that the snipers were kind of the most dominant weapon being used in some of the Crucible gameplay. But then an update came out last Thursday. What are some of the changes we've seen here, at least so far today?
So the snipers changed a little bit in the last update, but I don't think that's really the cause. Like, that's not really in play right now. The one-shot kills from the body, or one-shot headshots for supers, was one of the main changes. And really, we're just seeing teamwork at play here.
Yeah, a lot of the people that are sniping right now are still making those shots count against the players that aren't using their super. And for the most part, even if they land a snipe on the guy that's using a Stormcaller or a Blade Dancer, they're able to clean up after with their primary.
KJ Hovey was being shot from behind. He is going to be able to go up top. He's got support to back him up. Now waiting on that health to regenerate before he makes his push. This is a guy you play with. He's a clanmate. What's the best part of his game?
The guy is a robot with a sniper. The guy is amazing, and apparently he knows how to use a bow as well. That was the Night Stalker bow, the Void bow. It's able to shut down other supers by suppressing them, but also it's solid for taking out other players with a quick kill in case you're in a duel you don't think you're going to win. Right now, he's being very mobile, trying to stay up top. He's in a bit of a situation here with multiple players. Goes for the wombo combo and actually gets the double kill there. And it looks like he gets taken out, unfortunately. But there's a crest up top there. Hopefully his team can grab it.
Real crafty, and the rest of this Bravo crew trailing by 20 points. They need to get back into the action. Grenade's going out. He's going to try and get the job done with his hand cannon. And as he grabs the crest, Sir Demetrius is going to be pinching in on him. We'll go back over to our Alpha's team in just a moment, guys. It looks like Triple Wreck has his super available. Who else should we keep our eyes on in the big picture here?
After Triple Wreck, after using that super, I'm thinking we should go to Sir Demetrius, watch what he's doing. He's leading the team for Alpha. He's just consistent right now, winning his 1v1s. And Triple Wreck gets pinched by three opponents there. A little fusion rifle play from True Vanguard. I'm excited to see what they do. There's a bunch of chatter back there. They're actually starting to close the gap here. Only 10 or 12 points away from tying things up. As the superstar going out, I'm excited to see if they can pull it off, get the comeback going.
We're going to stay on board here with Sir Demetrius. You called him out. You said he's leading the Alpha squad. They are now just 40 points away from victory. Remember, it is the first team to 150, or the squad that is leading in points after our 10-minute game. Alpha is nearing completion of game number one, and it looked like Bravo brought it back within 10. Now Alpha starting to pull away once again after a big shotgun kill from Demetrius.
Sir Demetrius has a very balanced loadout here. He's got that pulse rifle for the range. He's also got the shotgun up close, and he's Nova bombing. Nova bomb, as we've seen, has been extremely effective in this playlist. He's able to win his duels with it or shut down other supers. And now he's pushing in. There's a couple players spawning back here. I'm not seeing any usage of that super because they've got, you know, there's been a bunch of situations here. He can just get that primary out, get the crest for free. No reason to use that super yet.
Demetrius is not missing shots. Sir Demetrius doing work. He's going to send his teammate in there to clean it up. And it looks like Say Wallbro and Sir Demetrius are just running around in tandem. There is the double team, and even though one is going to be dropped, the other is there to clean up the crest. Fantastic use of teamwork. 20 points to go still, as it looks like finally Bravo is able to reach triple digits, 132 to 100.
I think we should jump on pretty soon here with Luminosity. Oh, we've got another super though. We've got the blade going on Say Wallbro. Let's see what he can do with that first. But there's a bow down on the ground. He actually can't engage there because if he moves too close to that purple, he's going to get dragged out of his super.
We've all been here before, and this is one of the most depressing yeah. moments in Destiny. It looks like he will be able to get at least one crest out of it, but now the shotgun needs to come out, and he is going to clean up two kills there, grabbing the crest. 10 more points to go. This one is looking just about over. Let's take you to our final kills as everything is being denied.
I honestly expect him to die. That was just an unbelievable string of kills from Wallbro. He was winning his duels there, and his movement with his shotgun, very aggressive, able to close it out, and that sticky to shut down real crafty. That was a nice one to end the game with.
The man stayed alive for the last minute of the game there. After working with Sir Demetrius, he just caught fire. The Blade Dancer just showing off, and honestly, I expect him to be at the top of the leaderboard when we break down these numbers. Lars, Derek, what did you see here? Game number one, it's a classic map in Bannerfall, but this is brand new gameplay for a lot of people here in Supremacy.
Yeah, I think you saw some interesting things happening there in Bannerfall. Like, you know, it's funny, you saw sort of the reversal of Bravo, who's known for sniping, and Alpha known for shotgunning, and they really controlled, I think they really controlled the exteriors really well, like Alpha did. That's why they got that lead, and then they never let it go. Right. And it's about grabbing those crests.
Yeah, I was actually surprised that Walla, who's arguably on one of the worst subclasses for these situations, Blade Dancer gets shut down a lot by the other supers, but he was still able to use it smart. He wasn't getting shut down by the bow. He was waiting for other people to pop their supers, and you see he put 39 points on the board, Sir Demetrius with 40. They really carried it, though.
The young tag team going to work for your Alpha squad over on Bravo. I mean, you got 26 points coming from Frostbolt, but Lil Sonic, the guy we've been hyping up, he kind of had an off game for him. I mean, second best on the team, but not the 30 points that we're used to seeing from this man.
I think he needed to slay a little bit more there. He was grabbing a couple crests, but he just wasn't performing the way they needed. I'm excited to see what Real Crafty's going to do here. He had a very solid kill death in the last game, so hopefully the next map he can pull it out.
And there's a look at True Vanguard, the team player, as well as Lil Sonic, their star slayer. Will he be able to get it going? That was game number one, but we have four more maps to go, and from here on out, it's nothing but brand new stuff that you will see on September 20th when Rise of Iron is going to drop. Our first map that we'll look at, the new one, is going to be Skyline. Derek, tell us a little bit about this one as our players are loading it up.
Yeah, so as I said before, this is a large symmetrical map. There are opening doors that lead into the interior, and so, you know, keeping the interior or, you know, holding one of the sides is going to be key for these teams.
Are we going to see more shotguns? Are we going to see more sniper rifle play after watching just that game one? And let's talk about the primaries as well. Are we going to want to be rolling hand cannon shotgun on this? Are we going to see a lot of pulse rifles like we did in game one? What are you expecting, Lars?
I think it's going to be a mix, like Derek was saying earlier. But once they get inside, I expect them to be using more pulses and hand cannons and shotguns. But that exterior, you know, it's pretty hard to lock down, so you got to be careful. And what we're going to see here, my prediction is that the team that holds the center for the longest is probably going to win, but we'll see what happens.
Yeah, it seems like Alpha Team really likes to push in. All of them are pushing as extremely fast right into the middle here. They want to hold this down. And what they've been doing is trying to hold it down, grab a couple of kills, and once they've got their supers, they push out into the spawns and really start to mop them up. We've seen some double kills with the Golden Gun, with the Blade Dancers pushing in, and the Stormcallers.
You've seen his stream, now he's on your screen here in the competitive format. 6-on-6 Supremacy, if you are just joining us, welcome. This is the Destiny MLG Exhibition, showing off the new game mode that is going to drop in just a week. And already, it looks like Alpha is going to charge in and take center control.
You're seeing a lot of kills on the screen, people are going down. But the score is only 4-4. They're not grabbing the crest, they're being shut down, or simply can't push out towards the body. Triple Rec making a gear switch here. He doesn't feel comfortable with what he's got right now. That's going to change up how much grenade energy he has, how much super he's going to gain from his kills, things like that. But we're on top here with Luminosity. Haven't seen a ton of his gameplay yet, but he's been very consistent throughout the whole practice.
And this is a guy that is all over my Twitter feed. When I asked who is going to win today to the community, I said, is it Alpha Team? Is it Bravo? They said Alpha, and then they all tagged Luminosity.
Yep.
Why is he such a fan favorite?
Well, streaming, he's a very nice guy. You like to watch his stream. His gameplay is always top tier, and he is godly with his Shade Step. They call him Saint Shade Step, and his shotgun usage is some of the best in the game. You can see him flying in there, trying to chase him down. But there's some mobile little Sonic running around. He is kind of pulling the classic Sonic move, being fast, running away, and staying safe.
All right, now these aren't scoring for him when he picks up these blue crests, but those are going to be kills denied, basically. So solid play from Luminosity, making sure that Bravo, while they may be outslaying them by quite a bit, the score is going to stay close. And that kill up top is a big one to stay alive. Now he's going to rotate back behind Vile, who's running with the shield. And Luminosity is catching fire here, 3 straight kills.
It doesn't look like there's any opportunities right now to snipe. Everyone is inside, pushing in with their shotguns, and a True Vanguard actually going aggressive with the fusion rifle. Let's jump on with True Vanguard, see what he can do here. He's got a bubble now, and he uses this very safely, usually gets it to secure some special ammo or to grab a few crests on the map. The other thing is he's going to buff his team when the bubble goes down, so their primary duels are going to be a little bit easier to win.
Bravo, of course, losing game number one. So far, they're in the lead here. Game two, Alpha trying to come back, but now that weapons bubble is down, everyone who runs through it going to be just a little bit stronger, and there is the crest confirmed. Unfortunately, Luminosity is watching them from afar. This man has definitely been the difference maker for Alpha so far, and now you see Alpha will take the lead for the first time in this game, 38-36.
There's a couple more supers on the Alpha team right now that I'm seeing. Frostbolt's got one on the Bravo team and Cooch, but Vile, he's got a slam to really shut down and Cooch if he uses it. I'm excited to see once they start using these supers what's going to happen, but I want to see if Nkooch can push in here, try and get a couple kills with this Stormcaller. If they group up, it is devastating.
And this has been one of the most exciting supers in the competitive format so far. Derek, why is the Stormcaller so effective?
Well, especially in Supremacy, because it's basically a super-powered melee attack, you can just cruise around the map, really high mobility depending on what your perks are, and just mow people down. And because you're killing them at close range, you're picking up the crests as well.
Yeah, it's got a lot of AoE to it, so if they do group, you're able to kill multiple people at the same time.
Definitely.
And you have to be scared of the Stormcaller. If you don't have a super to shut it down, you're either running or you got to get very lucky trying to kill him.
So far, we have 3 players with their supers available. Frostbolt and Cooch, as well as Lil Sonic, all ready to pop them at any moment.
It seems like Nkooch is actually holding on to this because he hasn't seen any slams, but he's now popping it, finally pushing in. He has to be careful. And with the double kill, they're able to get both of these crests now. He's going to start rotating around the outside of the map here, trying to catch them in their spawn, but he has to be quick because that super is starting to run out. And as you can see, plays it safe, doesn't want to push in and get destroyed by all 3 players spawning there. Wallabra, again, on the top of the leaderboard. He's playing very consistently.
And I want to take our screen over to Lil Sonic. We talked about him being the star slayer for the squad. He's had some big plays, but mostly in the kill feed we've seen it. Let's see if we can catch one of them on camera. Grenade's going out to buy himself some time, but you see that tracker, it is all red. He knows the pressure is coming, and Vile will come in to secure that crest for the Alpha squad. Bravo, trailing by 10 now, need to get back in this game. Frostbolt is gonna be leading the charge.
There was only a 2-point gap just a few seconds ago, but After one solid push, they were able to make their way in. Alpha took the lead, and Bravo needs to start playing a little bit smarter. I think they need to get back inside. The spawns outside are a little bit tough. You kind of get farmed when people have their supers, and if Bravo wants to win this game, they need to control these inside areas.
Solid work here from Sonic. Waiting for the peak. He knows that there's Luminosity just around the corner as well, and smart decision here to bail. Two on one is never a fight you want to start, and he will be cut down. Let's take it back over to his teammate. Who do you want to watch here, MTash?
Let's check out KJ Hobie. He's got a just super that we just missed. That's okay. KJ Hobie's actually got a sniper out on this map, which is a little bit different. A lot of the players have switched to the shotgun, but he's got the wombo combo with the grenades there on Luminosity. Get some damage on him. I want to see if he'll post up and land some snipes here. If he can watch the doorways and catch people off guard, he might be able to make a couple plays with it. But Seiwala, again, with that win, he is not losing his duels right now. He's pushing in, getting those crests, and he's on the top of that leaderboard consistently.
Yeah, drop bodies and Seiwala, bro, have taken over for your Alpha squad. 76-64. We'll keep you updated on the score. We are halfway to the victory for Alpha at this point in the game. Super ready to go. When will he use it? He's got his two teammates charging in with the shotguns in front. He is going to go up with the hand cannon. Picks up one, fighting a second. Going to miss a few shots to the left of Hovi, and Hovi will be able to seize those crests. So Bravo, a nice push there, but it looks like Alpha is not slowing down.
No, absolutely. They're on fire right now. Unfortunately, when you're outside, the Blade Dance, unfortunately, isn't that strong. You really need to be in those close quarters engagements, because if people see you popping that blade, they're just going to run away. I'm guessing he's going to hold on to that until there's a couple targets, or he can start to pressure the inside, or he'll just do the opposite and run into the middle of their team. He's extremely weak here. If they focus fire him, it's going to be very tough to take him out, but he's coming in behind. Can he close the gap? And no, he's not able to close the gap on him. Throws the cheeky grenade, but let's maybe jump on with Real Crafty. He is slowly starting to pick things up here. He's got his primary out. Gets slammed instantly. But I'm feeling that Vile here is going to go on a tear. He gets the double kill, gets both the crests, and they're starting to, you know, really control this middle area here. They flipped it around. They're inside, and it's a lot easier to hold this out from those opponents trying to come in.
We'll go back to Real Crafty in just a bit. I know a lot of people in the chat would love to see this guy's gameplay, but I wanted to show you what Vile has been doing. He is the one who is just going to be denying all of the crests. He's the one who's going to be seizing them once the battles are finished. And of course, he was the person who shut down Real Crafty just a few moments ago. He's doing a great job of staying alive. And you can see he's putting a lot of trust in Luminosity to lead the charge, as he is coming in as cleanup, always the second or third man to enter.
Yeah, he's actually using a talent called Juggernaut on the Titan. It allows you to have a shield in front of you so you can tank bullets when people are firing at you. So he's using it aggressively, grabbing those crests, and able to get the points for the team, and rather safely with that Juggernaut shield. He's also staying to the outside here. As teammates are fighting, he's putting a couple body shots in, giving some extra damage, and really supporting the team on the outside of the map. Real Crafty, though, wins the duel against a player there. He's jumping on top of his head, giving him a little Goomba treatment.
Seiwala got the business right there, I'm not going to lie.
Yeah, absolutely. But still, A-Team is holding this down. There's a bubble in the doorway. They're going to start trying to rotate away from the bubble because they do not want to be fighting against players that have that buff.
And Luminosity has his super ready to rock. When is he gonna pop it? It looks like his teammate's falling in the front door. He is gonna shoot it out.
Misses the bow, but grabs him in the tether. So these players that are stuck in the tether take bonus damage. They can't move, and it's a nice play. Let's jump on here with Enkuch. Check him out. He's got a sniper. He's looking cross map. Can he go through the glass? And he's the guy ducks underneath it. There's nothing he can do. The glass, the strongest glass, bulletproof grade, unable to land that shot.
Lars, what is that glass made out of?
Unobtainium, maybe.
It's a relic of the golden age.
Yeah,
exactly what I was thinking. I knew that one. Lil Sonic doing work in your kill feed once again. You just saw him pick up two, seizing the crest as well. So Bravo, not out of this one, but Alpha is just 18 points away. Enkuch has got to get into the action a little bit faster. His teammates Frostbolt now warming up outside, and it looks like they're just going to try and group up as a six-man squad and run as a pack here.
Yep. The only person on this squad right now with a super is Sir Demetrius. He's actually going to push in, and he gets a quick kill. He's going to come behind them on the stairwell, but get taken out from KJ Hobie. And it looks like it's going to be one more game towards Alpha, a 30-point lead. This is actually surprising. In all the tests, they usually go one for one. And the last time they played, Bravo Team ended up winning this map. They secured that inside. I don't know what's going wrong for these guys.
Will Sonic is going to be trying to pop his super, but it is too late. This one is over. 146.
Big smiles from the guys on Alpha.
14.
They're playing very well right now. They're really aggressive with those shotguns, getting those crests.
So, of course, this is the 150, or the 10-minute time limit. This is the first time we've seen it go to time limit today. Players playing a little bit more passive now, knowing they're live on stream.
I think so, yeah. But I think Alpha's really gelling as a team. We saw them really working together in a way that we haven't, especially on this map. Bravo has been consistently winning Skyline matches.
Yeah, it's impressive. Maybe just their personalities have finally gelled, their play styles have worked together. Big smiles on there. Bodies is excited. He's pumped. He's ready to go. He's playing well.
How old is this guy?
Yeah, he's actually, I believe, 16 years old, 17 years old, and 5 days. No, 4 days now. It's going to be his birthday. So this is a young guy from New York, and he's an up-and-comer, I'm telling you.
Definitely going to be a star when it comes to private matches. PvP star for the day. Bodies doing work in game number two. Let's take a look at some of these scores. Of course, this is going to be Alpha up 2-0, but we're going to play out all five games. Don't worry. You're going to get to see all the new maps today. And Say Wallabra again at the top, Luminosity right behind him, and Bodies, who was leading the squad at the start, is going to finish with a 1.6 KD, the highest on his squad.
Yeah, I'm noticing with Bravo, again, real crafty, he's going positive. The guy's being very consistent right now, but it just seems that the big hitters, Lil Sonic, they're not, you know, he's not pulling his weight right now the way he was. And I guess, you know, Bravo team can't ask for the carry every game, but if they want to dominate the way they were earlier, Lil Sonic, you got to get those big Nova Bombs. You got to get those primary duels, and we're going to see, hopefully, a turnaround now for the Bravo team.
And, of course, that is real crafty on the right of your screen, rocking the nose ring.
Yep.
He had a few good plays in game number two. They need a big game out of him as we head to Floating Gardens. Next, Skyline and Bannerfall in the books. Alpha taking both of those, but now we're headed to Floating Gardens. Does this map play differently from the past two?
Actually, this map is playing a little bit differently than when we played it. A lot of the players are staying out to that outside apron and trying to hold that down. The bridge is very congested, and I think they want to stay away from that because they don't want to eat a grenade. They don't want to get a shotgun to the face. They're trying to keep those primaries out in that circle, and then they move towards a bridge, watching the spawns, using the snipers a little bit, and really holding down that top area.
Lars, Derek, anything to add before we jump into game number three?
No, I think MTash said it well. Like, the Floating Gardens has changed over the last day or so that we've been practicing, and they've seen that the bridge gets really congested, gets really busy, and so they've been pushing out to the outside. So we'll get a shot of that in a second here. I think the last opening shot here shows the apron that those guys were talking about, and that it tends to be a really crazy position. So we'll see what happens.
It's time to head to the Vex Temple here on Venus. This is Floating Garden game number three, Supremacy, the new game mode that's coming out with Rise of Iron. Of course, that is next Tuesday. We're jumping on board with Triple Rec to start things off for the Alpha team. They've won our first two games in large part to just consistent play and teamwork, and you can see already they're going to pick up first blood. Those crests are secured. Everyone from Bravo that challenged kind of ran in independently and were just slaughtered outside.
Yeah, 10 points right at the start of the game. They were able to really push in as a team there. They had a bit of flank from the bridge and then secured all of the crests. There was no real way to shut down that push. I don't think Bravo was ready for it there.
And two teammates are going to fall. One of the crests is denied, and now it's Bravo answering back. I'd love to show real crafty for a bit here. He was one of the players to pick up a kill, and you see him just secure that crest. The assist with Frostbolt picking up the shotgun kill. Now the hand cannon goes to work. Say Walbra answering back, though. Let's stay on board with Real Crafty through the respawn. And tell me a little bit about this guy's class. What is he running today?
He's running the Blade Dancer, which comes with the quick draw perk. He's able to switch between sniper and his hand cannon very quickly. If he magically lands a body, because normally this guy hits heads, he can clean him up with that that primary hand cannon. And he's also very shifty with that double jump.
Bodies is going to work here for the Alpha squad. He just charged out, picked up two kills, and there are the credits, the crest seized. And you see it's all green in the kill feed. Say Wallabra, Luminosity, all putting in damage. And I just saw Strength of the Wolf. Derek, yeah. Derek, all smiles. What's happening?
Yeah, Strength of the Wolf is a team kill streak, so you don't want to see that on the other team.
This is bad news for Bravo.
Bravo needs to get some kills. They need to start getting together. Alpha Team's just rolling over them right now.
32-12. They have a 20-point lead here. Supers are going to start coming up. They might start to run away with it if they can get some effective super usage here. I'm shocked right now. I'm shocked with how dominant Alpha is playing. And it was back and forth, over and over.
Your strong Slayers are nowhere near their supers either. Frostbolt and Kuch, Lil Sonic, all about halfway to their super bar, as you already see. Bodies fully loaded, ready to rock his super. He's got Say Wallbra right in front of him with his shotgun, and here comes the Storm.
They're all running away. Palpatine is chasing, but true Vanguard, he actually threw a suppression grenade, pulling bodies out of his super. An amazing play. He didn't get the kill there, but he pulled them out of his super when that could have been a very terrible situation.
Yeah, that could have been a lot worse for Bravo.
Yeah, absolutely. Bravo could have been dominated from that Alpha super. So,
over to Triple Wreck once again. He's going to see that shield go flying by now. It's the pulse rifle fight, and Kuch going to answer back. And now the teamwork coming into play. Alpha, three players jumping in. The shoddy shuts down the Blade Dancer.
Yeah, real crafty just got shut down mid-blade there. That was a great turn fire. Both of them really focused on the target. They didn't want him to move in with that blade, because if they missed those shots, they would have got a double kill right there. But Triple Wreck now has a golden gun. If he can push out to the outside here, maybe get some height elevation, he can jump in the air, get some free kills with his golden gun, but he needs to close the gap and grab those crests, or it's going to be wasted kills.
In the warm-ups, I felt like the golden gun was the most dominant super.
Yeah,
as everyone was getting triple after triple already. He's able to pick up one, instantly shut down, though.
I think that's a great trade from Sonic. Even though they both died there, golden gun still had two more shots. Sonic was able to shut him down. No multis gathered for the Alpha team.
And Bravo's starting to pull it together. They're closing the gap a little bit.
Yeah, 20 kills, 18 kills, and I'm curious to see what Luminati's going to do here. He doesn't have a super up. His grenades are down. His melee smoke grenade just came back up, but he's going to have to try and keep it to his primary, trying to support his team with his shotgun, and it looks like they're just mopping him out outside here. Now it is a 30-point difference. They keep going on these sprees, it seems.
Sir Demetrius just put in so much work, as you saw it in the kill feed. Luminati getting away with his life, but that tracker shows more pressure will be coming. Running back for some support here. It's looking like Alpha is going to try and group up and then make a push together on the outside.
True Vanguard popped his bubble. He's trying to support his team here with the damage buff. They've all got Weapon of Light, it seems, but there's just no engagements happening. They're on the outside, the other team is in the inside, and there's no gunfights really happening out in that area. The bubble is now down, and it's kind of even playing field now. Hopefully they can pull it back, though, because they're still 30 points behind. This whole map, they are seeming to be dominated by that Alpha team.
And Enkuch just went big, picking up three crests after his teammates got the kill. So a little bait and switch action happening here in game number three. Bravo, they had it within 20. They're getting blown out now, but they could turn it around. We'll see if this gameplay is going to change. It looks like everyone's starting to play outside a bit more than at the start of this game.
Yep. It looks like Bravo is also using a couple supers. Real Crafty just used his blade, but KJ Hovey, he has his super up. Hopefully he can get a shutdown on another super using that Void Bow, or just a quick kill in a duel. If they can secure these crests, if they can secure this top area, there's a comeback. There's 4.5 minutes left. I think they can do it. I believe in Bravo right now.
KJ Hovey just waiting for the push with the super so he can shut him down.
Stormcaller's now out for Enkuch, but we're going to stay on KJ Hovey here in case there is another super. He's just leaving that guy. He waited for his teammates to clean it up. He's trying to really hold down this bridge area, but it looks like they're starting to rotate, actually. It's starting to rotate as a team now a little bit more. I like this. Three players here, three players back on the top shrine area, and now there's a Stormcaller. He's going to try and use his bow to shut it down. Body's blinks out of it, but he gets captured with the suppression, pull out of his super. Huge play from Hovey.
No direct shot there, but he did enough to stop it. Now we'll see Triple Wreck trying to escape, and Triple Wreck will be cut down. So Alpha, they're still in the lead, but the score, it's getting a bit closer. I want to see what's going on here with this Alpha squad for a minute. Vi was leading the scoreboard until Say Wallabra took over. Right now, he already has 22 points, make it 24 after grabbing those crests. Let's see how he's getting it done. It looks like mainly the kills are coming from the hand cannon play.
The hand cannon play, and for whatever reason, those sticky grenades today are on point. We are seeing one or two a game where he's just able to do it. Unfortunately, he pushes into pretty well the full team of Bravo there, who are still trying to hold down that top area. But they need to do something. They need to get aggressive here. There's three crests up top, but it looks like Vile got all of them. What we saw before with that Juggernaut Titan, he was able to push in, get those crests, and he's putting score up on the board even without killing the enemy team.
The boy is not missing. Going to work is Sewalbra. There goes the grenade. Not going to pick up the kill, but it should buy him some time. Gets around the corner to stay alive, and he sees one more opponent. The melee connects. Can he hit the shot? No, he will not. Sir Demetrius, though, is fully loaded with his super, ready to go with his Warlock class.
Nova Bombs have been huge so far. They're great for getting the multi-kills that we saw earlier, but they're also very nice for when there's a 1v1 engagement. You're losing, so you pop the Nova Bomb and win it. A very consistent super because it shuts down other supers. All the Voidwalkers today seem to be playing overall very consistently well, and they're dominating the scoreboard, it seems.
Frostbolt has been spotted, and Frostbolt hits all of his pulse shots there, so the pulse rifle on both sides, but much stronger shots coming in for your Bravo team. The score, though, this is starting to become a bit of a blowout, 32-point advantage. Another kill coming in from Sir Demetrius as he is going to get payback on Frostbolt. Now, the
real
Blade Dancer comes
using
out.
Using the Blade Dance, he now just got a double kill. He's pushing towards the bridge. A triple kill if he can turn it around. His teammate gets the kill. So they got four kills right there. Pick up the pieces, grabbing those crests, and looking at the scoreboard here, or looking at the teams, Enkuch still has a super. Frostbolt still has a super. So I think Bravo, if they can play well here in this last minute and a half, they might have an opportunity to come back.
They got
need
a chance
to win, though. Win these ones.
We see some strong Arc Blade coming out of Real Crafty, but Lil Sonic just used his bomb, and it looks like he was able to pick up two. Real Crafty is going to grab those crests, but now Alpha answers back, and it looks like KJ Hovey will have to stop their push. Vile doing work with the grenades, but now we're running out of time. 138 to 110, a 28-point advantage. Alpha should be running away with this one unless Sonic can turn it around right here with the shotgun.
I don't think they did enough with their super advantage. They had three supers on the enemy team and one kill apiece. It's just not enough right now to come back from 30 or 40 points. I think just Alpha has it. They've been holding down every engagement. They're winning their ones. They're using their supers at a solid time. I don't think Bravo's got it this game because there's only 6 points left and 55 seconds. Very tough to win.
We'll take it over to Demetrius as he is trying to pick up one of the final three kills. And time is ticking off the clock. 44 seconds to go.
He's playing it a little bit safe there. There was a crest across from him. Sometimes you have to be careful, though. If you push out for a crest, sometimes you can kind of get baited into a shotgunner or a sniper across the lane. So he liked to play it safe there, but with this close, with this lack of opposition from Bravo, you might want to just slide in and grab those crests.
Bravo
the game
is
now
making a huge last-minute push, but it is just one kill separating them from defeat. Will they be able to stay alive and pick up some massive wins here in the last 12 seconds? One at a time, these Alpha members are being picked off. Those crests are coming in and being picked up by Bravo. Can they do it?
Nope. Unfortunately, going to get turned around. It's going to be turned off. Vile coming there, grabbing some kills at the end. I thought the comeback might happen with that change, but there just wasn't enough time.
At one point, there was 26-point lead for our Alpha squad. They cut it down at the end, but they couldn't get it done. What did they do right, though, at the end of the game that they should have been doing earlier, Lars?
I think they were sticking together better at the end. I mean, you saw them come back a couple of times, but each time they did that, you know, they were sticking together. There was an amazing play by Crafty. We saw that triple kill with his Arc Blade. That was awesome. But at that point, it was a little too late, and they weren't able to hang on to that or make up for the deficit that happened earlier in the game.
I think one of the biggest things with Alpha is they are so used to being aggressive, to pushing, collapsing on the enemy team, that it's just ingrained in them. When they see an opportunity to outnumber the other team, they're taking advantage. Where the Bravo team, because they're snipers, they like to do their own thing. They like to sit back, they like to support, and I just don't think they're getting to the crests with the same aggressive manner as Alpha team.
I could do this all week, man. This 6-on-6 stuff has been super fun to watch. Exciting gameplay, but so far it's Alpha up 3-0 in our 5-game series. If you're over on Bravo, now you're just trying to avoid getting whitewashed here. Got to avoid the 0-5. Looking at the stats, though, who did the big damage, Amtash?
Well, The funny thing is Vile went negative, but he's leading the score. He's got 30 points on the scoreboard because he was running in with that Juggernaut shield. He was getting the crests.
Yep.
And, you know, carries the team with those points despite going negative. It's very impressive to see. And then you've got someone on the other scoreboard with 31 points, Lil Sonic, who goes 1.44 kill death. And so this guy is slaying. He's grabbing crests. He's getting points. But so different how you can win a game.
And True Vanguard, I mean, he's been playing for the team, right? He's been trying to stop a lot of the enemy supers, but while he's so focused on that, I feel like he's not getting the kills that we have seen from him throughout all of the warm-ups. I need to see a little bit stronger play out of him, maybe switch up his subclass potentially even going into game number four, because whatever they're trying to do isn't working on Bravo.
I'd like to see maybe a switch to hammers, because there's six players on the map. The Sunbreaker hammers are devastating. If you can get some chains going, you might get a double, triple, quad kill. Go for the breaker. And if you can shut down an area with that Sunbreaker, everyone's scared of him. They're not going to be trying to secure those crests. They're going to be running for their lives.
Guys, let us know on Twitter, what do you think of the new map so far? You have seen Skyline. You have seen Floating Gardens. Coming up next, though, we're going to have Last Exit. And this is the first one we talked about at the start of the day, Lars. Lots of up-close and personal action inside the tunnels, but there's still some room if you want to pull out the pulse rifle, the scouts at times.
Yeah, outside there's going to be a lot more long-distance, you know, medium or long-distance range, but, man, a lot of this map is inside, and you'll see in the subway tunnels themselves. If one team can hold that interior space, like, again, we'll see what happens. If you know, Alpha does the same thing they did in Skyline, they might be able to hold it down, keep Bravo outside, and control the space, which is super important.
The guy I want to watch off the break is Sir Demetrius. Sir Demetrius and Sir Walla Walla, bruh, yeah. Just seem to have become the tandem. They both have S names running together. One of them will jump in, start the fight, the other one finishes it, and then secures the crest. Are they going to continue to do that on game number four? Remember, the players, they haven't had a whole lot of time with these maps yet.
Yeah, they're still learning it. They're running around. I've seen a lot of wasted supers because they don't realize how long it actually gets, you know, takes to get from one area to another. But overall, I'm excited to see this. Bravo won more games on this map than Alpha did. So hopefully they can pull out the win here, make this a little bit closer. But right now, all of a sudden, things are starting to slide towards Bravo's favor. 6-2, I called it.
6-2,
Bravo. 6-2, Bravo.
Bravo with the lead.
As they all get killed by Vile and drop bodies, it's now a tie game. That's the thing, with these guys, with how talented they are, you're going to see big sprees from everyone out here. The score is going to go up so rapidly. It's hard to anticipate what's going to happen on every map.
And Derek, can you explain to me what I'm seeing on the tracker in the upper left-hand corner of our screen?
Yeah, so all the dropped crests show up as little white diamonds on the tracker. It's not always possible to keep them in your head while you're playing, while you're in a fight. But when you're in a slow spot like Sir Demetrius is right now, like, you can definitely plan your approach and maybe pick up some crests instead of getting in the engagement first.
And of course, those green dots on your tracker, those are your teammates.
Yep.
Generally, we have seen throughout the day, when those green dots are clumped up, that is the team that is about to win the fight and the one that will walk away with all the points. So far, though, it is a tie game. Alpha bringing it back. Very passive play so far, as no one is really willing to charge outside. Almost. I'm wondering, though, is Bravo going to get a little impatient and charge in here and just feed some free crests? Look like that's exactly what's happening now.
Yeah, it looks like that's what's that's happening. Bravo, I think, needs to try and secure this inside area. Even though they aren't leading, well, it's tied up now, but I think overall, if you're outside, you're going to get picked off by the roaming supers like Golden Gun, and just securing those crests inside, it's a lot easier to defend the crest and shut down the other crests than it is in the outside area where there's some hills and they're rolling down and getting away from you.
Looks like Real Crafty has been singled out now. He only has one teammate to his right. The rest of his squad, though, pushing in from the left. I love the patience on the push. Now he's going to be able to secure those crests. Bravo maintains in the lead, 26-24. A very tight opening, though, in our first 2:15. Let's keep our eyes, though, on Real Crafty. He was heating up with the sniper outside. Now it looks like his hand cannon is on point.
Yep, he's going to be trying to stay alive in here with that hand cannon. It's one of the best up-close duelers in the game. And if he can grab someone outside with that sniper rifle, I think he's really going to try and scope these lanes, have some players feed into it, and hopefully take their head off.
This is not a forgiving angle at all for Real Crafty. If the shotgun pushes up on him, he better hit the sniper shot.
The lucky thing is he does have quick draw in that class, so if he does, he lands the body, he can, you know, switch to the last word, get that quick kill. But look how close it is right now. There's only a 2-kill lead. Everyone's freaking out, saying that Alpha is going to take it, but this is a close game, and supers are starting to come up. Hopefully, we can see Bravo use those effectively, and Enkooch just got a triple cap with those crests.
There's orbs being dropped by Vanguard, of course, so Vanguard not always getting the kills for his team, but definitely helping his teammates secure their supers. Let's take it over here to Frostbolt and Enkooch for now. It's going to be Frostbolt on your screen.
A huge Nova Bomb there that was wasted. He got the kill, but Frostbolt able to shut down all of those crests, stopping any sort of progress for the Alpha team. I like that play there. And a smash from Vile. Let's jump on here.
Take
very
it away,
quickly
man.
With KJ Hobie. He's got his super. He uses the bow to shut down another super right there, it looks like, or another player. But he can't push out the door because there's a player all the way across that field. This is a tough angle for them.
Cooch is going to pop his Storm Hands. Not going to happen, my friend. Lightning Bolts not connecting from his Storm Trance. And got to be a little frustrated after that because he had at least 3 kills lined up for him outside. It seems like the two teams have switched positions. Bravo now fighting from the inside as Alpha has locked down the outdoors.
Right. They're rotating a little bit more to the train section of the map. We haven't seen a lot of this. Normally we're seeing them on the outside area and kind of leading to the pipes room. So it's interesting how the map has shifted now as the game progresses. With Bravo 12 points ahead now, finally getting a bit of a lead here. And it's not even from some great super usage, it's just consistent play, getting these crests and winning their ones.
Another bubble being dropped by True Vanguard, his teammates able to use that damage boost to pick up some nice kills as Bravo continues to pull away. This is the largest lead they've had so far in game number 4, in fact, arguably throughout this series. And now all the denies coming through as well as the secures.
They're
Vanguard
starting to
is
run
turning
away
this
with
off.
This. Frostbolt actually just got a triple kill, giving them 6 free points, grabbing those crests. They've got another super. He just used that super. They're generating orbs right now. They're spamming their supers, essentially. And if they can keep this up, they might take this lead 20, 30, 40 points.
And Lars, this is the teamwork that we saw out of Bravo in the warm-ups.
Yeah, it's funny. Like, this is what I was expecting, and now they're finally working into it. You see True Vanguard popping his bubble, giving those guys orbs of light, which is going to let them get their super faster. He's moving that position around the map, giving them a safe place and giving them weapons of light, which also makes them a lot more deadly with their primaries.
Real Crafty, actually. Again, another super here. He's been very consistent with his Blade Dance. He's getting multi-kills. He mains Blade Dancer. He plays it all the time. So usually when he pops his super, people are going to die. Unfortunately, he gets a little kill stolen, but there's a lot of players in the inside here. If he can close the gap, he gets one. He gets two.
Oh, yeah,
there's another
up,
in the corner. Three, and the triple down. He's also, unfortunately though, going to get shut down from those crests. The teammates were able to go in. Alpha, 3 crests seized. And I mean, that session there, 4 crests seized now. That's 8 points right there trying to make a comeback. Even though Real Crafty got that huge kill, it didn't skyrocket their lead, which is very interesting to see.
We'll stay on board with Real Crafty for one more life. I want to see what this man has been doing. Definitely went to work in the last minute. Now working behind Frostball, who's going to lead the charge. He's going to deny a crest as well as land a grenade on drop bodies. Hovi is there to answer back on Vile as well. So a nice even trade in the game, and it looks like their 16-point lead now starting to diminish though. Just 9 points separate these two squads.
They need to be careful here. Enkooch actually just used his Stormcaller and was shut down. Bravo team is running out of supers, and Alpha is starting to accumulate a few here. So if they're not careful, they are going to really get snowballing here. It's almost tied up right now. Actually, Alpha taking the lead, 105 to 98. That's amazing. Well, it was 30 points behind almost there.
Yep. Yeah, Frostbolt has his super up, but he's the only one on the board right now.
Only one on the board with his super, and of course, he is on your Bravo squad. We're going to stay on board with Alpha for a little bit here.
Little Sonic actually just got a huge kill against Walla, shutting down the special ammo, then won a duel with his Nova Bomb. They're still in it. It's only 1 point difference. Bravo just taking the lead. Let's see if Say Walbra, unfortunately gets taken out as well as Sir Demetrius. The team shotting right now from the Bravo team. This is the teamwork we're talking about. They're shutting down areas and they're winning their ones.
Alpha was up by 8, now trailing once again by 9. A big shotgun coming in from Luminosity. He's going to pull out that pulse and evade very nicely. Nice shadow step coming into play here. Now tell me about the Shade Stepper, my friend.
Shade Step is an interesting ability. It allows you to dodge tracking grenades. Once you Shade Step, it kind of takes you off the map for a second. The grenades lose where you are, but it also confuses the heck out of your opponents. When someone is good with their Shade Step, someone like Luminosity, it's hard to keep tabs on them. They're going to run away and most likely shotgun you in the teeth. And it's pretty frustrating to play against when someone knows what they're doing.
Another bubble is down for Vanguard. So everyone knows, stay away from that area. Anyone who comes out of that bubble is going to be dealing extra damage. And Luminosity, he's going to make that call. Unfortunately, the only player on his tracker who is running away from it. And you can see Bravo now pulling away by quite a bit. His teammates not making the best decisions to close out this game.
Yeah, Luminosity was actually running away from a Blade Dancer. He decided to pop his bow. It allowed him to get a free kill as someone was tethered, but I think it was a bit of a wasted super there. The blade was almost out. There wasn't really anyone in the area. The super usage, if they want to come back, needs to be a little bit smarter. But from what I'm seeing, Alpha Team still really rotating well on these supers. That bubble is coming in huge for True Vanguard, creating those orbs. They've got another super with Enkuch, who just had his. Little Sonic has another. But Luminosity doing work with his shotgun here. He's going to try and duel here, but that super just too strong. Enkuch rotating around now to try and get some bodies. He is obviously going to try and slay them, gets another one. He's not too worried about the orbs. He wants to kill people here. But there's a crest right there. Doesn't want to push in too aggressively there, trying to throw some grenades, tag the opponents, keep them away. Sometimes you can bait those crests, get a couple of free kills, and come out on top.
Just 6 kills and 6 crests away. Is your Bravo squad make it 8 as they pick up 2 more Frostbolt doing the work with the shotgun. Now, the pressure coming in, the Blade Dancer out for Sewalabra. He's able to pick up one, looking for a second. The shotgun trying to chase him down from behind. And Bravo now just 6 away. On the other side, Alpha mounting a bit of a comeback.
And a triple kill just now from Frostbolt. Mm. He's got 45 points. This is the most points we've seen from any player. He's on fire. I almost wish we were watching him because his Fist of Havoc right now, his slams are on point.
Mine, all mine, I'll do it myself, were the last two things to pop up on our screen. What does that mean, my friends?
Mine, all mine is you picked up your own crest, or the most crest without assists, and I'll do it myself is the most crest picked up.
Wow.
Over 40 points.
45 points. That's insane.
That's amazing.
He wasn't one of the guys that we were saying is going to carry. We didn't say he's the Little Sonic, but he's been consistent all day. So when someone like him pops off, it really helps the team. And that's what they needed. If they want to come back and win some of these games, they have to have everyone performing.
All smiles now for Bravo as they finally get their win. It took them a few, but they get the job done. On last exit, we have one more map. Icarus is coming up, but before we get there, we have to take a look at some of our statistics. Let's see who did the most damage on both sides. Of course, it was Frostbolt with 45 score. On the other end, Sewalabra at the top once again with Sir Demetrius. They have been so consistent for the Alpha Team, but the difference maker for me, it had to have been the way that we saw the supers being used.
Yeah,
absolutely. Constant use of teamwork from inside. Is this map going to play out similar to Icarus, which we're going to see next, or is this going to be totally different gameplay for game number 5?
Yeah, I mean, it depends on where the teams position themselves, I think. Last Exit is very asymmetrical and has some pretty obvious places to hole up. That cafe we saw got a lot of work on that leads down into the pipe area, as well as just outside and at the bottom there. Icarus is a lot flatter. It's a lot less verticality, but there's definitely places to post up outside the tanks and, you know, right in front of the interior space.
I'm really excited to see how they decide to play it. They're either going to go inside, really try to hold it down, or you're going to see the snipers like Hovey. You're going to see Real Crafty staying to the outside by those tanks. And if they can't close the gap, they can't get in on top of those snipers, they can pick them off very easily. Bravo, maybe they'll run away with another win here.
Bravo, down 3-1, but they could go out on top in our final game. Icarus is going to be our last game in our 5-game series. This is the PlayStation 4 exclusive map. And talking to Bodies over from the Alpha team, he said, by far, this is my favorite. This is my map. Yep. So I think he is going to be my player to watch over on the Alpha squad. When you look at Bravo, clearly Frostbolt is the guy who came alive in Game 4. Is there anyone else we should keep eyes on?
I think we should stick on with Hovey for a little bit here. He's been consistent. He had a 1.7 kill death in the last game. He didn't put up a lot of kills, but it means that he's surviving. He's supporting his team. And I'm guessing, you know, I wish we could see how many assists he got throughout that game. The other guy, Luminosity. He went absolutely off last game. 2.12 or 2.0. Even though they lost quite handedly in a lot of their engagements, he was still double positive. That's insane.
His movement has to be some of the best we've seen today as well. Luminosity's movement has been absolutely on point. Bravo, though, answering back. They have the confidence going into our final map of the day. Once again, guys, let us know, what do you think about the new game mode? What do you think about the new maps? Are you pumped? It's coming out on Tuesday. You get a chance to play with all of your friends.
I've been talking with a lot of the players, and they've played a lot of Destiny, and they're saying that they're liking Supremacy a lot better than Clash, a lot better than Control. And I think it's that feeling of, if I shut down that crest, you know, it's neutral game, or if I grab the crest, we're making progress, and it feels like a very fun objective to play. It's a lot of chaos, and overall, they're big fans. So those guys like it. Those guys, I mean, they've got a pretty good idea of what's fun, because you should see them after hours.
These guys are used to 3v3s. Yeah. Today they're playing 6-on-6, and they've been loving it. I can't wait to get into this final one, though, and I said Bodies is going to be my player to watch. Let's go to him right away. Once again, he is going with his Warlock class. Tell me about his primaries, though.
Well, he's got the Grasp of Malak, which you get from the Omnigal Strike. It's a very fast-firing pulse rifle. It's almost like an auto rifle, like a machine gun, but it's got that range advantage. So with the shotgun and the pulse rifle, he's kind of got a nice long range if they end up trying to snipe him. But if they close the gap, he can shotgun melee using the max range lightning strike to the booty. Huge plays. And look at the positioning of Team Alpha. All of these crests on this side of the map, they're all grouped up, able to shut it down, but a sneaky play from one of the Bravo players actually secured one and stopped a push there. So the lead isn't going anywhere for Alpha. They're only 6 points ahead here. Let's see what they can do moving forward with Wallabra.
Yeah, guess who's on top of the leaderboard already?
Wallabra.
Once again, leading his squad. And earlier we were talking with True Vanguard. He said, yeah, it's gotta be easy playing with this subclass that you're using. What is it about this subclass that might be helping him out to be on top of the leaderboard game after game?
It's funny that he said that, because he's almost throwing a little bit of shade, because Blade Dancer is one of the tougher ones to use in 66, but his movement, his primary game is what's on point. He hasn't gotten a ton of multi-kills with that Blade Dancer because of the difficulty and the ability for the other team to shut it down. But Wallabra is outplaying his opponents again and again, getting those crests, shotgunning, pushing in, and again, winning these duels. He's on fire right now. Great. 10 points for the Alpha team, right from Wallabra. That's huge.
And Vile already with 7 points as well. He has been the crest grabber for his squad, knowing how to play this objective game mode. It's going to be Alpha up early already, a 10-point advantage. They keep playing like this, so this could get out of hand rather quickly.
And Cooch right now is actually using a shotgun and the Hawk Moon. Hawk Moon, a very powerful hand cannon. If you get lucky, it does bonus damage on some of the bullets, so you can get some crazy engagements. He gets a nice shotgun kill, still pushing in aggressively, and another kill for the double. And Cooch is going huge here, securing those crests, getting those kills. A triple down,
jeez,
but a smash from Vile to
shut
that down.
It would take a super to stop him right there.
Yep.
The boy was going in. Let's stay on board with him. Coming off the respawn, his super is fully loaded. He's ready to go. And honestly, it's been his shotgun that has been most impressive throughout the day for me.
Yeah, and he's normally a guy that snipes, so watching him be so successful with that shotgun, the guy is skilled. It doesn't matter what he's using, but he's gonna do it. Oh, and it looks like there's a Blade Dance here, but we should stay on Nkooch. He's got his super up. He knows that a slam is down. If he can get an opportunity to use the Stormcaller, he might put up a bunch of points for the Bravo team.
You see his teammates picking up those crests, even though he was dropped. Unfortunately, Sir Demetrius just came out and dropped a huge Nova Bomb, picked up 3 straight kills, Alpha grabbing every single one of the crests. It's 52-36 just when it was starting to get close.
Now, we are seeing a shift towards Alpha here. They're starting to run away with it a little bit, but anything can change with the super. It's Real Crafty now popping his Blade Dance. He's gonna start pushing in. Real Crafty with his first kill. There's now a bubble down. We're going to start seeing an aggressive push here from these supers, trying to close the gap, get those kills. Wallabra sneaks in and grabs that crest. I think that Nova Bomb needed to go a few seconds earlier to shut down that push on the crest.
And you see it just took two shots there with the hand cannon. Let's take it over now to True Vanguard, the man who's been dropping the bubbles.
He's using a Lord High Fixer, and he's actually using a fusion rifle. I think the only player using a fusion rifle right now, which is a bit of a tricky weapon to use in these competitive games against some of the best players in the world. That is a very aggressive fusion rifle pick.
He was saying, man, I just want the Isoluna so bad.
Can't get it. He can't get lucky.
He's one of the few here on the main stage who does not have it yet. But this man, Frostbolt, leading his squad. Once again, he dropped 45 score in game number four. Now loaded with his super. He's got his shotgun. Plenty of ammo.
That was a great grenade positioning. He was able to kill Sir Demetrius with that grenade. He placed it on the wall. Most likely the enemy team is zoned from that crest because of the grenade AoE. So even though he died there, I think that was a pretty solid grenade. I want to see what he does with this super, though. I'm curious if he's going to try and shut down someone or just use it aggressively pushing in. And we're getting a lot of crests from Bravo right now in this middle of the map. Yep. They've got another kill, and he's got a bit of pressure on him. This might be a situation where he wants to use that super. Go for the multi-kill. Go for the gusto, but say Wallabra takes him out, and again, on the top of the leaderboard.
They cut the lead down to 6. Now it's back up to 10, and it looks like we're going to see a little bit of a changes made by Lil Sonic. Did you catch exactly what he switched out?
He actually switched to the grass with Malik. I think he wants to keep the ranged gameplay going. I think he was just losing his 1v1s with his primary, so he wanted to try and switch it up, see if it's going to change. But that might be a bit risky in the middle of a game when you're already used to that primary. Hopefully he can turn it around with that grass.
Is this something that we see a lot amongst the sweaties, a lot of changes mid-game?
Sometimes people just get frustrated. Their shots aren't connecting because they are, you know, they're rushing and they're not landing their shots when they're in those 1v1 situations where they need to win. So they make a change. They, adjust their play style. And some of the times it works, but some of the times it honestly hurts them more than helps them.
If you look at the big picture, we have Luminosity with his super, Triple Rec with his super as well. And let's go over to Triple Rec now as he pops the Golden Gun.
He needs to start pushing in towards the spawn, see if he can pick off some targets. Because of Golden Gun's slaying ability, able to take out Real Crafty, jumps in the air for Little Sonic. He might get the triple kill with
nice.
The primary, go with the shotgun, but he can't close the gap on KJ Hobie, who uses the smoke bomb to the face, shutting him down.
And you did see, say, Wallabra in the third person there, grabbing 3 of the crests. So nice teamwork. He calls it out, and then say Wallabra is there to do the objective work. Alpha pulling out.
Yeah, the slaying power right now. Alpha is really on point with their super usage and the crest usage. You've seen Wallabra sneaking in and just grabbing a crest for free at times. And I think, unfortunately, the Bravo team isn't grouped up enough. They're getting picked off by these supers, separated, and Alpha is just ramming it down their throats over and over again, pushing in with the trade. But once again, look at the teamwork. They grab the crests, the other team doesn't. That's what's setting Alpha apart right now. There's a 28-point lead, and with only 3 minutes to go, 40 points total for the win, this is going to be tough. Alpha really needs to hold on here, and Bravo, they have to make some drastic changes if they want to win this game.
Say Wallabra's getting so aggressive, and it's not going to pay off for him. He's trying to coordinate with Bodies, and Bodies will be coming off the respawn with him. So both players trying to take a new angle here as all of the Bravo team has grouped up outside. Is Bodies going to come on the long flank here? Can you do it by yourself? How many kills can you get with his loadout currently?
Well, if he can close the gap with his shotgun, that might be a free kill. But the issue is if he rotates around the outside of the map where it seems that Bravo is staying, he might just get picked off for free. So getting that flank, getting that push might not be worth it unless you're using a super or something like that in Supremacy. In Clash, where you're just slaying people, it might work, but not here.
Taking you back over to the Bravo squad.
And Cooch, he's been on fire today. He's been playing very well with that shotgun. On this map, for whatever reason, it seems to flow for him. But he's going to get pinched here. Everyone's on his tracker, but he wins that one. Cannot get away, though. And that's where, unfortunately, Bravo's falling apart. They're just by themselves all the time. Alpha pushes in, gets the kills, gets the crests. And any kills that Bravo is grabbing right now isn't leading to score, isn't leading to them catching up.
Lil Sonic doing everything he can, but he is just being double-teamed. Now you can see a 4-man grouping here from Bravo, trying to switch up the strategy. everyone running around the perimeter together. And now they'll find the action, two players at a time being taken out.
True Vanguard's actually using a grenade to try and suppress the enemy team, but throwing those willy-nilly grenades, wasting them when there's no super up, I don't think that's the play that needs to be done.
Willy-nilly.
Willy-nilly.
I like that.
Oh, and he comes up from behind. He actually almost took out the golden gun without any weapons there. He took a fist to a gunfight. I like the plays. A little bit too aggressive.
And we were half a second late there.
Apart.
Frostbolt came slamming to the ground in the middle of three people. Didn't get a single kill. Let's go over to Seywallbro once again as he has his super ready to fly. Sir Demetrius coming off the spawn will have one, as well as Triple Wreck is on a 5-kill streak now. We're going
to
see the Arc Blade.
I'm curious to see if his Arc Blade is going to get a couple of kills here as a few more supers are up. Bodies just use a super as well. Things are getting aggressive, but unfortunately, Wallabra doesn't really know where to go on the map. He's kind of just dancing around on the outside.
Yeah,
I don't know.
I think he misread his tracker.
Yeah, really. A little bit of misreading on that tracker. 4 points to go until Alpha wins it, takes it home, and a huge Nova Bomb! But unfortunately, he doesn't get a bunch of kills with the Nova Bomb, but he's able to clean them up after.
And that will do it. 152 to 102. They went over the score limit to close things out. What a finish here for our Alpha lineup. This squad was the favorite according to Twitter. When we watched them in warmups, it was so much closer, but on game day, this team performed.
I think it's because they got up early, they were doing some jogs outside, they were ready to go. Alpha, they wanted to prove that they were the top team, and I'm sorry to say, I just lost a bet.
You are the smartest man at the desk, Derek. You called this from the first moment of the show. The Alpha team living up to the hype.
Yeah, they had a very aggressive play. In warmups, we saw that it didn't come together as a team, but on game day, again, they just gelled. They did it.
And in that final game, was there anyone who stood out to you, or was that just a team effort?
Well, at first, Enkuch was doing so well, and then I saw Real Crafty played had a nice blade dance, and I was really thinking that Bravo had it. And then it fell apart. It just seemed like they weren't pushing together as a team. They weren't securing those crests. And once again, Wallabra at the top. You've got Sir Demetrius, Luminosity. Those three guys were consistent every game, putting up points. But still, look at those kill-death ratios. They were dominant this game. It was a slaying. It was a massacre out there. So I don't know. I don't think Bravo had a chance on this one.
1.27, 1.69, 1.89, and a 2.0. are your four players at the top of the Alpha leaderboard. Everyone going to town on our final map. Body said this is definitely going to be his favorite game mode, and it looks like they were able to show off on Icarus. This is the PlayStation 4 exclusive. Lars, Derek, any big takeaways from this final game?
You know, I was just, you know, other than being wrong about Bravo, I'm sorry, guys. Sorry about that.
We wanted to have
You know,
faith.
We tried. But yeah, like we said, the games were a lot closer in the practices. But, you know, that's what happens. Game day happens. You know, teams come together. Teams fall apart. Someone's got to win. Someone's got to lose. Supremacy proves that, right?
Yep.
I loved it. Supremacy was so fun to watch. I'll be honest. I was kind of out of Destiny for a while, been busy traveling all over doing different shows, but after seeing Supremacy today and after watching the new maps, I know I will be back next Tuesday. You've already agreed to carry me,
help me get
my gear up ready for the showtime. But any big takeaways on the day for you, Derek?
Yeah, no, I mean, this is just exciting to see really high-level play all in one place, showing off private matches, showing off the new stuff. It's just good stuff. So, yeah, I mean, we're super excited about Supremacy again coming next Tuesday, September 20th, with Rise of Iron. 4 new maps, you know, one exclusive to PlayStation. And, you know, today, as a special thank you to the Destiny community, we're going to go ahead and turn on private matches for everybody. So if you're on PS4 or Xbox One, log out of Destiny, log back in, and you've got it.
That's right. You got the new consoles. You're going to have the new edition of private matches. Who are we playing first, M-Tash? Who are you carrying me against?
Well, first, we need to do a little 1v1, because I saw the talk you were saying over there. I heard what you said, but I think we're going to go take on the Alpha team and show them who the real MLG pros are.
Well, we want to thank everyone for watching. Make sure you get that reset ready to go. We're going to be playing here live from the venue. For now, though, that is it for the show. On behalf of Bungie and everyone here at MLG, thanks for watching, and we'll see you on Destiny.